Speaking honestly, I don't know what a hit record is. You want to know a secret? Nobody does. If you're a basketball fan, you might be familiar with the term system player. A system player is a player that excels within a system. Take the player outside of that system and he'll struggle to succeed. There's a system set up for what classifies as a hit in mainstream music, and the songs are structured to fit that system. What often gets overlooked is that any record can be a hit. There's no definitive type of record, no definitive type of sound. There's billions of people in the world with different tastes in music. What it comes down to is reach and percentages. For instance, what if only 0.04% of the people who hear your music will buy it? That seems like a really small success rate, but consider this. If you got your music heard by 1 billion people, that 0.04% would represent 400,000 sales. You'd almost have a certified gold record. Now, the more people you reach, the more likely you are to find people that will buy your music. So how do you reach people? Through radio and television. Radio and television shows reach billions of music fans on a daily basis. Your song can be played on the radio or television once and be heard by millions of people all at the same time with that one play. Now, the two outlets, radio and television combined, are the most effective way to reach massive amounts of people in a short span of time. When it comes to assessing a hit record, what's looked at is the potential a song has of making it into rotation on radio or making its way to TV. A song that sounds like what's on the radio is viewed to have a greater potential of getting radio airplay, which result in more reach and potentially more sales. The formula of making a hit record comes down to getting a producer with a track record of getting radio airplay and or getting features from artists and songwriters with track records for getting radio airplay. This strategy fits the industry's system because record companies have the money, connections, and resources to get their artists' music on radio and television. With radio airplay, a song will reach so many people where even 0.04% as a success rate will represent a large number. At the same time, songs tend to be played on radio stations and shows that serve the audience of their genre. Such a low success rate could indicate that a strong majority of the core fans of the genre aren't moved by the record. Like, a hip-hop song is going to get played on hip-hop radio stations. Now, a hip-hop song that's reaching millions of hip-hop fans and only converting 0.04% of them, that indicates that that song isn't popular amongst most hip-hop fans. Now, as an unsigned artist or indie artist, you probably don't have success or have access to billions of people. So if you pattern a record behind records on radio that only 0.04% of the fans of your genre are moved by, that means you're only going to convert that same percentage of whoever or however many people you reach. For example, if you reach 1,000 people, you probably won't even get a single sale, like zero. You'd be making music for a system that wasn't built for you to succeed in. The greater your reach, the lower your success rate can be. The lower your reach, the greater your success rate needs to be. Where we don't have the advantage of radio, we do have the advantage of the internet, where we can target and find the people who are most likely to be responsive to our music. And we can target in different ways. We can target through remixes. We can target through covers. But one of the most effective ways to reach a targeted audience is through online ads. Online ads put you in complete control of the people you reach. On platforms like YouTube and Facebook, you can target the fans of artists similar to you. You can target people by interest. Like if your music appeals to skateboarders, you can target people into skateboarding. I mean, and online ads on a platform like YouTube, you get what you pay for. I mean, and you get to set what you want to pay. So it's like you can get 1,000 targeted views on YouTube for $10 at a penny per view. And I'll soon be posting the results of a recent video campaign I ran doing exactly that. Now, make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe to the channel. You know the drill. This is Gift signing off. Pay us no mind. Peace.